Hey guys, Get Level here, and today we're going to be talking about social media pop-ups, kind of like this one right there. Now, there are different ways and different methods of accomplishing this. There are different types of use for it. People use it in their YouTube videos, just like I just did, and some people use it for their live stream. We're mostly going to be focusing on the live stream aspect, but if you use a broadcasting software to record your YouTube videos, then you can do that too. If you use Streamlabs OBS or OBS Studio or anything like that, you will be able to use this video's technique in order to add your social media pop-ups. All right, let's get into it. Now we're gonna go with a very simple way today. We're gonna create an image for different social media tags, and then we'll just use Streamlabs sponsor banner feature in order to cycle through them. So it's kind of a slideshow, but it looks good. The other way that you could achieve this is by going to your motion design software, creating a little animation, it pops in, it cycles through the different tags, and then it disappears. And then for 5 minutes or whatever time you want in between them, you just leave that blank. Of course, you would have to either export with a transparent background or use a chroma key. But I want to make this accessible to everyone, so we're gonna use the first method that I mentioned. All right, so I created this. This is going to serve as our social media banner. As you can see here, we have our TikTok group. It's just a Photoshop file. Don't worry, you do not need Photoshop in order to customize this. I will show you how to do it later on. But basically, there's this, there's Facebook, there's YouTube, there's Instagram, and then there's Twitter. Technically, in each group, there's a text file. All you have to do to type it, to change the name is going to be just double click on the text and then boom, you put your tag. If it's too big, just, you know, make it smaller. Here, I have it on a transparent background. So what you want to do is save as a PNG file so that it exports it as an image with a transparent background. I've already done this, as you can see here. Boom, 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 boom. Pretty easy so far. So the next step is to go to streamlabs.com and then log in with your Twitch account. So in the top bar here, you can type sponsor. And sponsor banner is basically the social media pop-up widget. Don't worry, if you're using OBS Studio, that's what we're gonna use today. If you're using Streamlabs OBS, you can just add source sponsor banner and then do everything there. But if you're not, then that's fine. You click on sponsor banner, it will bring you here. So here is the sponsor banner widget. So you can see you get a couple of options that are, you know, very useful for this particular instance. You know, hide duration, how long do you want it to not be showing? Widget show duration, how long do you want it to show for? Banner width, height, image animation. This is, you know, what is gonna make it kind of look fancy. Background color, we're gonna keep that to transparent, but if you wanna add a background color, you can just pick one. Then there's placement double, single, keep it single for now. We want them to show one by one. And then here you have your images. Right now there's only the Streamlabs logo. So one thing I will give you as an advice is try not to have this different aspect ratios for your image. Make sure that all your images are the same aspect ratio, the same size, the same shape, pretty much. Don't go from a wide rectangle to a square. It's gonna look kind of awkward, and it's gonna create more problems than you want to have. So top here is actually showing you what the animation would look like. In order to make sure that it updates, you need to click save settings, and then it will see this is bounce. Bounce in is like the default one, I think. Okay, so we're gonna use this. All right, so in order to know the size of your image, what you wanna do is go ahead and hover over it. And here it says 711 by 250. Now I shouldn't get that a little bigger. All right, and now we can start uploading our images. Now, if you wanna add images on top of images, boom, you can click add image here. But let's go ahead and change this one. Let's click change media. And here I'm gonna click, and then I'm gonna upload those images. Select them all, click open, and then wait for a second. When this is yellow, basically that means that something is uploading. I wish Streamlabs had something to indicate you the upload progress, but it just doesn't. And sometimes it just doesn't upload, so you might have to upload it one by one. As you can see here, just nothing happened. So let's go with Facebook. That's the Instagram. Technically, you can upload them one by one while you're adding images, but I like to have them all in my gallery. Okay, so that's four. I'm gonna select the first one, which is gonna be my Twitter, because it's like the most important. If there's a order of importance, you can do that. So image duration, that's how long you want that specific image to stay on screen. I'm gonna put 5 seconds. Actually, I'm gonna put 2 seconds. I want this to go kind of fast just because I'm showing you. Okay, 2 seconds, I'm click add image, change media, and I'm gonna go find another one. Let's go with Instagram. Boom, 2 seconds. Add image, change media. If we click save setting, I believe it will show us an example of what it looks like. Okay, so those are pretty big. Obviously, you're gonna want to resize them in your broadcasting software or recording software. But keep in mind that here, the widget show duration is set to 3 minutes. That means that it will cycle through them for 3 whole minutes. If you want to do the math and you have 4 times 2 seconds, basically your whole animation lasts 8 seconds. You put 0 here and then you put 8 seconds. That's the time basically you would require for them to go, for it to go through all of those, and then it will go into that invisible state, which will last 2 minutes. Don't forget to save. And then boom, disappears after that. You can play around with all the animations that you have. There's a lot of them. There's a lot of them. That's the one I prefer. There you go. That's clean. All right. So now if you're using OBS Studio, how do you add this to your actual live stream, or how do you add this to your video recordings? Okay. So top here, it says widget URL. Okay. You're gonna click copy. It will copy your widget URL. And then here in OBS Studio, for example, you can click plus and click browser. You can name it whatever you want, pop up. And then you replace this link with the one you just copied. I just controlled V. If you want, you can follow the exact size that you want, but this should be good. This is way bigger, but it should be good. And I can't see my preview right now, but I'm guessing the social media thing is there. I'm going to enable the preview. And here I'm going to do something in the properties. I'm going to click refresh browser when scene becomes active. Is that every time you switch to that scene with it, you can disable this if you don't want it. It basically restarts the whole browser source. And there you go. And if you don't like it, you can always, if you don't like how big this is, you can crop it. I'm holding Alt. And there you go. And if I turn this off and I turn it back on, does that work? No, but if I switch, oh, it does. Never mind. There you go. And you can size it however you want. Boom, boom, boom. All right. So technically I've shown you how to customize this PSD file. This PSD file, by the way, will be available at gumroad.com/GAL level. Okay, you go there, you download it, and then you'll have exactly this. There's no need to install any fonts. The font that I'm using is called Calibri. It came installed with Windows, so you won't have any problems with that. Just open up the group that you want to change your name, and then just double click on the text and change the text. Now, if you do not own Photoshop, which I absolutely understand, you can go to photopea.com. Okay, so we're here in Photopea. You're gonna click open. You're gonna find that PSD file. Okay, so it's the Photoshop file right there. And you're gonna open it. And look at that. Would you look at that? For free online, you can do that. And if you wanna change the name, same thing. Double click on this and put. And then, of course, same thing. If you want to export it, just click save as. Or export as PNG. All right, this is good. Click save and boom, it downloads it for you. Okay, now it's going to be in your download folder, so you can just grab them from there and add them to your Streamlabs. So that's how you create an easy. This is the easiest way I can think of creating a social media pop-up, especially for live streamers. The PSD, the project file for you to create your own based on what I did, is going to be available at gumroad.com slash guy level. Another thing is join the Discord if you have any questions, if you're struggling or whatever, just join the Discord. We have over 1,000 streamers there, and if you have any general questions about streaming, this is the place to be. Leave a comment if you would like for me to make an animated version that is more similar to what I have for my YouTube videos. In that case, that could be used both for live streaming and YouTube videos with video editing software. Just let me know in the comments if you would like to see that. Huge shout out to Beastly Bitty for tweeting my latest video. That video was about how I created a soundboard using my Stream Deck. Thank you so much for tweeting my video. It really helps me out. And if you tweet my videos, maybe you'll get a chance to appear here on the screen as a shout out. But that's pretty much it for today. Go follow me on social media. Subscribe if you're not subscribed yet. Ring that notification bell. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching. Go out there, make me proud. Get level out.